Hey everybody, welcome back to this week's episode of Flick News. Isola here, and if you're new, this is a segment on Flick Direct where I give you the information that has been released in movie news. So grab your popcorn, sit back, relax, and let's get this started. First up, reshoots are underway for Captain America: Brave New World. And you know what that means. The rumors are true. Giancarlo Esposito will be part of the MCU universe. The reshoots that are taking place in Atlanta are supposed to last about 22 days. And these reshoots are probably to add Giancarlo into the movie, which didn't get the best of reviews during the pre-screening. So hopefully adding him will actually make those pre-screenings a little better. Now, it is said that Giancarlo will be playing the villain. However, don't hold me to that because that's just a rumor. Don't know if that's true yet or not. But he does play a pretty good villain, so I can't see that being a bad thing. I know some are pretty upset because of the pushback, but honestly, this is a good thing. They're actually listening to the audience and making some changes. I wish they kind of did that with a few other MCU releases from the past, but we can't really go back and fix those now, unless if you're a variant from another timeline in the multiverse and have a time stone, maybe. Be sure to check back, because I'm sure we're going to have more information soon on those reshoots, maybe some behind-the-scenes stuff, and you know how I love to share that stuff with you. Last week, I shared with you that there's a new Knives Out movie coming, and it's called Wake Up Deadman. Now, we really didn't have much information on it because they were still working on the script, but we at least got the title and that Daniel Craig is reprising his role as Detective Blanc. Well, this week, they have shared with us pretty much the entire cast, and it's going to be great. Let me share with you just a few of the names. Well, I'll share all of the names with you that I've gotten so far. It's Glenn Close, Mila Kunis, Kerry Washington, Daryl McCormack, Selena Spaney, and our very own Hawkeye, Jeremy Renner. Now, they also announced that Andrew Scott, my favorite Moriarty in the Sherlock universe, will also be playing a role in this movie. I wonder if he's going to be the villain. I mean, that's kind of obvious because he plays a really amazing villain. But who knows? Maybe they'll go that route, or maybe he won't be. They always have a twist and a turn, so you never know who is actually the bad guy in these movies. But even if the obvious choice is taken, you know it's still going to be good. The characters haven't been released yet, but I'm sure something's going to come down the pipeline soon. Hopefully they'll update IMDb, or we'll actually get it from the horse's mouth. We'll just have to wait and see. So come back and I'll let you know who they're playing. It was announced this week that National Treasure 3 is in the works and that the original three actors are returning to reprise their roles. I mean, I don't know who you'd get to play Nick Cage's part. I mean, you could probably do something, but it's Nick Cage. You kind of need him to come back for this. I also love these movies because they mix fact with fiction and some adventure, so it almost gives you an Indiana Jones kind of feel. And I absolutely love those movies and anything that has history in it. Director John Turteltaub announced that the script was being written by a good writer and that if everything goes well, the movie will be made. He also hinted that Sean Bean might be reprising his role as Ian Howe. I wonder in what capacity. Who knows? There's multiple ways that this could occur. He could still be in jail, and they need to ask him some questions because he's somehow associated with whatever they're looking for. Or he escapes or is let out of prison and then goes back to his old villainous ways. I don't know which one I like. Which one do you like? I think I kind of like him still being in jail, and then maybe he breaks out after they talk to him. We'll just have to wait and see. No matter what, for me personally, I'm just excited to hear that something's in the works, and hopefully we'll hear more about it soon. I hope that good writer really knows what he or she is doing and that they get it done, because we need this movie. Finally, it was announced that we are getting a new Masters of the Universe, and Nicolas Galatzin will be playing He-Man. Now, I know that I have mentioned this time and time again on this channel that I love cartoons. I really do, and I loved Saturday morning cartoons. He-Man wasn't really one of my favorites, but because I had a brother who's 4 years younger, kind of got stuck watching it. And honestly, it kind of grew on me. You know, they had some great characters, which I absolutely love now. And I always wanted a battle cat. I mean, who didn't want a big cat that you could ride? Takes you everywhere, super fast. But alas, that never happened. It's probably a good thing. Anyway, you may recognize Galatzin from 2021 Cinderella, or the one that keeps popping up on the commercials of my streaming service every 5 seconds, which is driving me crazy, The Idea of You. Now, Galatzin actually has a beautiful voice, so I may watch it. I don't know if it's really my kind of movie, but if not, I'll just listen to the soundtrack just to kind of hear some of the songs that are on there. Now, when I heard this, I had to go and see what Nicolas looked like, and at first I thought that the casting was completely wrong. When you think of He-Man, you're thinking of someone like, I don't know, Alan Ritchson or Henry Cavill, because they can just really get big and bulky. But after I looked him up and saw some photo shoots that he did, the guy's got guns. He can actually bulk up a bit, so I think this is actually going to work.
Okay, guys, I apologize for the impromptu interruption. I was just going to leave it at He-Man, give you a little bit more information, but you know what? This is more important. I am so disappointed in myself for not giving you this important information that was released this week, and that is the photo from Ryan Reynolds of what the popcorn bucket is going to look like for Deadpool and Wolverine. This right here. I think I'm going to buy it. Are you going to buy it? I think we need to buy it. Anyway, back to your regularly scheduled program, which is basically the ending. Enjoy.
And with that, this concludes this week's episode of Flick News. Be sure to like and subscribe to both of our Flick Direct channels to ensure you get all of your entertainment news. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.